But first, here's what's going on in politics tonight. As we're going to talk about good news on the job front, the national unemployment rate, it's down. Experts are saying still not a reason to celebrate. See, the rate unexpectedly dropped to 7.8% last month. That's the lowest level in more than 3 years. Well, businesses added 114,000 jobs, but economists are pointing out that that number isn't close to what the economy needs to heal. And when you factor in the unemployed, so that's people working part-time, they've stopped looking, that rate remains near 15%. Well, this report, as you might guess, getting mixed reaction. President Obama says the new report is a reminder that the country has come too far to go back now. Mitt Romney, well, he says it's really not what a real recovery looks like at all. And so now, joining me to talk about these new numbers, economist Steve Beaman of the Beaman Group. Steve, welcome back to Politics Tonight.
Thank you, Paul. It's great to be with you.
So it's been a real mixed day, and maybe because we're so close to this political presidential election. Because to hear 7.8%, the first time that an unemployment number has gone below 8%
yes.
since January of 2009, it's been a long time, the best numbers really since then, and yet Republicans, I'm not asking you a political question, but Republicans saying, no, it doesn't look like what it says. So tell us what really means.
Well, the economics community was a little bit confused by this. We had forecasted 113,000 new jobs, so the actual number from the employer survey came in right at 114. But that number should have saved that 8.2% unemployment number right at it.
So it should have kept the unemployment number where it was.
It should have kept it there. Okay. So this number came in at 7.8 because the household survey that the Bureau of Labor Statistics does also came in a little better than expected. So it created some confusion. But to your point, there are different measures of unemployment. There's what's called the U2 number, which is the 7.8%, and there's something called the U6 number, which is the one that the Romney camp is pointing to that shows a 15% unemployment scale on a broader basis.
So, but as we pulled apart a little bit, my understanding is ordinarily the reason this rate would come down in past months is because some people have just fallen out of the market. They're just not looking for jobs anymore. But my understanding is that's not what this was about. This was actually about some adjusted numbers from the last couple of months being much better than expected.
That's correct. In fact, we had talked a few months ago when the numbers came in, there was concern right. they would be moved down. We're looking today at about a 1.3% annual growth rate in the economy, which is not real strong. So we're cautious about these numbers. I think everybody was pleasantly surprised that the household survey came in as strong as it did. And we all want this economy to turn around, so we're looking for these optimistic numbers. But there is some concern that this could be a data blip. And so we don't want to get overly enthusiastic about it.
Now, I do have to ask you about this. You know, those who it didn't take long until the Twitter sphere started going. And, all right, somebody like Congressman Alan West in Florida, maybe it's to be expected from him because he's such a staunch right-winger. But Jack Welch, I mean, he's also very conservative, but, you know, as a business person, I'll be honest, I was a bit surprised that somebody like Jack Welch came out and said, Chicago is cooking the books. Now, these are not the numbers, but somehow, I guess, David Axelrod and crew got in there and made this happen. Look, you're an economist. Is there any way that could even happen?
It's very astute of you to bring it up. The answer is yes. I mean, government does have the ability to play with these numbers a little bit. And there was some question that came out about donors within the Bureau of Labor Statistics today and their relationship to the current administration. So it's possible to do it. I think to bring it home to people, when you look at the inflation rates, for example, government calculates the cost of living for Social Security purposes without food and fuel. Well, that clearly artificially lowers inflation. And these labor numbers can do the same thing. So you want to look over a longer period of time. You don't want to get caught up in one number. But I think generally, especially the Obama camp's going to look very comfortably at this and say, hey, we're on the right track, where I think the economics community is going to say, let's just wait and see a little bit. We're happy about it. We're cautiously optimistic, but let's make sure it's real.
And it makes sense. And when I say, can these numbers be fudged with, obviously interpretation, that, you know, listen, you can make numbers look any way
that's
you want.
Right.
But I think that the accusation that has been coming in has been literally, these aren't the real numbers, that Chicago changed the numbers. Now, that's not possible, is it?
It's possible.
I say Chicago,
but,
you know.
It's possible. But I think what you're getting to is we're so close to the election,
right.
coming right off the debates. People are so hot to find a political cause behind it. But the numbers speak for themselves. And when we see the numbers coming out, we look at them in the months to come, we're going to see. And more than that, people feel this recovery. They know with their neighbors if it's getting better. And
right.
that's the real measure.
Part of the shift, I think, is also a huge number of baby boomers retired. That impacted this. But just finally, let me ask you, stock market unchanged. So do we expect to see much of a boost of these numbers? Or even though it's relatively good news, it just is what it is?
It is what it is. And the market right now is most concerned with the fiscal cliff that we're headed toward January 3rd of 2013.
Okay. Steve Beamer of the Beamer Group, thank you so much
thank
for
you.
Explaining all of that.